Hey everyone, welcome back to Fix My Linux. In today's video, I'll walk you through what's new in Ubuntu 25 Plucky Puffin, a fresh release that brings several exciting updates for Linux users and GNOME enthusiasts. Let's dive into the features, UI changes, and under-the-hood improvements that come with this release. First up, GNOME 48 brings a subtle but clean refresh. You'll notice that icons and layouts are now better organized across the system, giving a more polished look to the Ubuntu desktop. Let's open up the Settings app and explore the changes section by section. In the Network tab, the Connection Profile view now provides a more detailed breakdown of your IP configuration. When you go to add a manual proxy connection, the layout has changed. Instead of the old pop-up window from Ubuntu 22, each proxy type now has its own section below a toggle, much easier to manage. Over in Display Settings, key options are now available right up front in the third section, making them more accessible. HDR support is also included, but it only appears if you're using an HDR-capable monitor. In sound settings, there's a new startup sound toggle, so you can enable or disable Ubuntu's boot sound, finally. The power section is now divided into general and power saving tabs, which is a small but welcome improvement. The new tiling behavior settings let you tweak how windows tile on the screen, a nice touch for multitaskers. Inside apps, removable media, a great security update. By default, auto run is disabled, meaning any USB you plug in won't automatically execute applications or potential malware. You can turn it on if needed, but this is a smart default. Now in the sharing section, you'll see fewer options than in Ubuntu 22. Only media sharing is visible here now, but don't worry, remote desktop and remote login haven't been removed, they've just been relocated. I'll show you where in a moment. One of the most exciting additions is the well-being section. You can now monitor your screen time, set break reminders, and limit usage. For example, when the screen time timer ends, the screen turns grayscale to give you a visual cue to take a break. There are also eyesight and movement reminders. You can set your own intervals and get alerts. A thoughtful feature, especially for devs or techies who sit in front of the screen for hours. The keyboard section now allows you to set custom global shortcuts that work across all apps. A small but powerful productivity boost. Let's revisit the system-level sharing options I mentioned earlier. You'll now find Remote Desktop and Secure Shell under System, Remote Access. Remote Desktop has two sections, Desktop Sharing Remote Login, and right below it is Secure Shell SSH, which you can enable for remote access or management from another system. Ubuntu 25 now uses Wayland as its default windowing system and ships with GNOME 48 and Linux kernel 6.14, bringing performance and compatibility improvements. A few app updates. Ubuntu 25 now includes a new default PDF viewer called Paper. It's lightweight, fast, and replaces the older document viewer. The GNOME text editor also received a major boost. Now you'll see live document statistics like word and character count as you type. No more pop-ups or manual refreshes like in Ubuntu 22 and 24. You'll also find formatting tools, indentation, tab space, and document type neatly grouped under the new info icon. And that's it. These are the most notable updates in Ubuntu 25 Plucky Puffin. Let me know in the comments which feature are you most excited about. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Fix My Linux for more Linux tips, tutorials, and tech updates. See you in the next video.